Yeah, if I'm gonna start streaming, I don't think I'm ever gonna be one of those high energy streamers. Ah!
Hey, Quinn! Forget when we do this. What is this shit?
I really hate the food options there. Otherwise, I'll make big salads. And that's
the far range.
Really close to the casino, huh?
Well, he has more combos with 10-9, so... But I feel like we should still keep Starling here at a relatively high frequency. Definitely some hands that are gonna hold on the turn. Here... Not exactly sure. Those are the spots I'm very, very unsure about. But I am gonna give up this time. I'm not sure if Rex are calling that hand or folding that hand.
I was betting because I felt like, well, it seemed one of the best follow-through hands with the 10.
Yeah. Not sure whether there are like any pool reads with regards to call down frequencies on those brick runouts. Like, are people gonna fold their top pairs there or not? And also unsure about how many jack x they get to the river with, because those are obviously folding.
Jack x probably is calling. Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I mean, we had good blockers to the straight, but I'm not sure how relevant that is, because I feel that that hand would raise the turn quite frequently, given how deep we are. Ooh, we have aces. Maybe Magica wants to play. Magica does seem to want to play. At least for a call. We'll see if it's down to invest. Six as well. Bisky is in as well.
My small ISO, by the way. Please don't fold.
Maybe I should make it bigger. Like, oh, we lead. We're just calling. We're just calling. I don't think there was any folding versus this guy. We're just gonna get it in here as well.
Wow, so you've held twice now.
It seems that way, yes.
That's pretty positive.
So not sure what I'm supposed to be doing here. I guess betting and getting it in. Probably. Feels like that. What worse hands am I getting called by? King 10 suited, King Jack. Definitely could be in the 3-bet range. Ace King. If I'm not getting snapped, then I guess I'm not losing. Oh wow.
Okay, now you can, if you wanna write the notes about those as well, then you know.
Yeah. It's whatever, got it in really good. Get flat here. Pretty good board. I can have all the sets. He probably doesn't have all of them. I'm just calling, as I would with my entire range. That's a good turn as well. Definitely continuing here. I have a lot of hands that he can try to make fold. When he checks... Not sure if he's gonna check stuff like... I think I wanna probably bet versus like jacks, queens, ace 10, stuff like that. don't expect to get check raised at a very high frequency. If I do, then I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. Das Bat. Do I have a time lag?
I don't know if it comes up then.
Yeah. Again, I feel like I should be folding. The timing was really quick. People probably underbluff these spots. He would have to like super quick time, put it in, check raise with like ace queen for this to be a call. And that's probably not gonna be the case in like a random ML 200 game.
You have trips. It's going down. Hotsanico says it's going down. Well, yeah, it started off pretty well.
We're gonna check raise here. We have many missed draws.
Oh shit, Wooden Poker is auto hosting with 6 fucking viewers. We probably doubled our viewers now.
Probably. Probably fine to call here.
Call.
Oh, that sucks.
But you have 3 pairs now. Why is that so bad?
Well, I'm not sure if he's gonna bluff this card, and we can put in a small value bet, I guess.
So this is what you call value betting. That's why you wanna have this guy in the game, because he's value betting right now.
Rep a small value bet, I mean.
I got myself. It's not GTO.
Fold out like king queen.
He did not like the river.
He has the Siemens though.
Yeah, monetarily it's been a fairly tough year for me, but I was actively keeping a diary at some point, but I kind of left it on the side for a bit, and now I started it again, and it's really helpful to put your mind or your thoughts from your mind to the paper, like get it out there. I think I've been really attached to it, the results, and given that the job we have has so much variance, I should really be able to find happiness and enjoyment from, like, try to find it in other ways than only from results, because most of the days as an entity, especially if it's, you're just gonna have a shit day, then if you only results matter how you feel emotionally. And now I'm trying to find more enjoyment from if I make a good play, if I find a leak in my game that gives me a chance to improve my game and come back as a better player next time. So yeah, try to focus on that and stay happy, because I can play a game for a living. And yeah, fucking life's pretty good. Like, really doesn't matter if I keep losing another half a year. Well, probably then it maybe already matters a bit. But other than that, it should feel good. I can still go outside, do healthy activities. Health-wise, it's been going really well for me lately. A lot of improvement. But poker-wise, actually been moving down stakes a little bit as well, just not to fucking blow up.
Life's definitely really good, and it's, I think, gonna be good pretty much regardless of how we do in the project. So many things to be grateful for.
That mic is a bit too far from you, but Ben, come closer. I'm here, bro. What do you want? It's probably too close.
That was probably annoying as hell.
I can clap as well. I've been told that clapping is not good.
Stop. Why are you doing this?
Show us how you celebrate winning that part.
How I celebrate?
Yeah.
I don't really.
You do. When you do that hey, hey, hey thing. Hey, hey, hey.
I try not to celebrate usually, but generally I feel that like celebrating or being sad about variance is just a pretty unproductive use of mental space. I think there's some tension though between how much emotion you want to show if you just want to maximize your EV, and how much emotion you want to show if you're a streamer. Because if you're doing it partly to entertain others, then I think people probably enjoy if you have like high energy and celebrate your wins and cry when you lose. It seems at least that like the most popular streamers like Tonka and Lex are pretty emotional about how they're doing.
They seem to be. Emotional wings.
Yeah, definitely like super emotional.
Fucking emotional wings. Stop being emotional.
And I understand as well, like...
I know what you have to do, you have to jump next time. If things don't go your way, just jump on this box. Go like rage. Would you do this for the stream? Come here and smack this box with your leg and then sit down again.
Right now?
Yeah, like rage quit. I see the X is on the box as well. You didn't even check if there was anything inside.
I trusted you. So yeah, if I'm gonna start streaming, I don't think I'm ever gonna be one of those high energy streamers.
You could be the one who's the lowest energy.
Yeah. I'd be very successful competing in that market. I'm gonna count this as my yearly charity, so I'm gonna donate less to the organizations I usually donate to this year. I've done my good deeds.
After losing an ad. This is how we're gonna do it.
We're gonna check raise here. This is something I have studied. Usually check raising these spare boards is really good. But we shouldn't be barreling many turns because people don't float light enough. King obviously is not a good card at all. We're just gonna barrel diamonds with this combo. Give up otherwise.
Can you go like 130-ish here and then go like box jump?
Ooh. I'm gonna overbet this card. I'm gonna try to make a cheeky bluff. See what happens. It worked!
Oh!
Gonna be going for the three ball versus Bisky. I'm going bet, bet, bet on most runouts. Not sure about this one. Well, that's a decent flop. That is a decent flop. Gonna be check raising. Betting now. Not sure if we should keep betting on a 9x. Maybe we should because he's not gonna have that many 9x in his range. Here we wanna make it a price that I think he can call with ace high. Maybe this is too large. Not sure about that. Here betting is actually bad, probably. Because we're splitting with all of the aces anyway. So are we making him, are we getting him to call King X? Probably not. Can he check back 9X? Probably not. So that's not gonna be a concern, but I just think we're gonna have a higher EV when we check there and let him turn like Jack 10 into a bluff. So I think this was a pretty bad river bet, honestly. So overall, I think we did good. Won a bit of money. Not too much, maybe a couple hundred euros. As I said before, that's a result that is definitely above expectation. So yeah, I think I might make some of those cash game streams in the future as well. Mostly gonna stick to MTTs though. If I have any deep runs, probably gonna fire up the